news and weather.
Good morning to you. Welcome back to First Edition. Outside, still have lots of rainfall moving through and some thunderstorm activity. Let's get right to it. Here's our radar imagery. Most of that now is focused, I'll call it near the South Shore and then farther toward the north. When I say South Shore, the South Shore Lake Pontchartrain, we'll get in just a bit tighter. You can see all the lightning strikes here. So right around Laplace now, just to the northwest of Laplace, seeing some of that rainfall move through and then in a line extending all the way up into St. Tammany Parish and Washington Parish. As we slide on over toward the North Shore, Bogalusa, you're about to see some of this rainfall probably impacting you in the next 30 minutes or so. And then down along the Mississippi Gulf Coast, as you can see, just a gust of moisture continuing to move off the Gulf of Mexico as we've got a warm front that's getting just a bit closer. Bay St. Louis all the way to Biloxi. Showers and thunderstorms now around downtown New Orleans. We are getting a bit of a break, but notice there is another line of showers that is approaching. And if you have to cross the causeway, get ready. If you have to cross it, say, in the next hour, showers, thunderstorms, and windy conditions is what you'll have to deal with. Now, Central Lafourche Parish, seeing some showers moving across there and also right around Lafitte. And you will see this moisture continue moving through as we continue through the day. Some of the rainfall totals over the last 12 hours, got 4 inches just in St. Tammany Parish, almost 3 inches just south of New Orleans. And you get along the Mississippi Gulf, rather the southeastern coast of Louisiana, 6/10. And then along the Mississippi Gulf Coast, about 3.1 inches. So getting our fair share of some rain and all these little dots and icons indicating that this is all hail. We've had reports of hail near the metro area of New Orleans, also down back off toward the southwest in St. Charles Parish, also in Terrebonne Parish. And we knew this was going to happen. Also, severe thunderstorm warning does remain in effect until 8 a.m., so pay attention to the weather. Probably going to see a little bit more of this activity. And then a flash flood watch remains in effect through this evening, looking at 2 to 4 inches of rainfall possible. It's going to be one of these days. You've seen this before. Temperatures right now, they're trending mainly in the 60s, 61 in Hammond, Slidell, 61 in Galliano, 67 in Grand Isle. And the winds, they're going to be ramping up. They're kind of variable right now, but they're running about 15 miles per hour by this afternoon. We're expecting winds to run between 20 to 25 miles per hour. That's why the wind advisory is now in effect. Well, will go into effect at noon to 7 o'clock. So we'll pick this up, the forecast model, by noon. Notice what happens. I think this model underdoes it a little bit. 2:30, a few showers. By 6 o'clock, this model keeps all of the heaviest rain just off the coast. As we get into the overnight hours by midnight, the rain is done. Like I said, I think this underdoes it just a little bit. We are going to be getting our fair share of showers and storms by this afternoon. And we are going to keep a slight risk for some severe weather. The main threat is going to be severe thunderstorms, damaging wind, and hail. An isolated tornado possible, but that's not going to be the main focus. I think it's going to be those heavy downpours, the damaging wind, and the large hail. So for today, mid to upper 70s, showers and storms, they'll be likely. Remember that slight severe weather risk. It's going to be windy. And then overnight tonight, mid to upper 40s for the most part, decreasing rain. And then we'll get some overnight clearing. The winds will be with us. Take a look at your 7-day exact cast. After we deal with this rainfall for today, things turn out to be pretty nice. Notice what happens. Lots of sunshine. But on Friday, things cool off. Mid-50s by Friday. Lower 50s by Saturdays. By Sunday morning, 20s and 30s for morning lows. So after we get rid of the umbrella, we'll have to grab that heavy coat because it's going to get cold the latter part of the forecast period. All right, there's your First Edition look at weather. Randy, back to you.